Hi there! In this video, we are going to talk about scrollbar, horizontal scrollbar. In this case, we have this app, and when it reaches a minimum point, we no longer want to reduce the gallery width, and instead, we will show a scrollbar to the user. The same rule applies when we have a gallery that's too wide for the place in which it's inserted inside. So imagine we have a gallery that needs to be very wide and the screen is too narrow, and you want to show the horizontal scroll bar. Okay, so let's see how to do that. Let's suppose that here, once we decrease the width of the app and we reach, let's say, this point, we don't want the gallery to resize anymore. We want the gallery to keep this width. But once we keep resizing the screen, we want a scroll bar to appear here in the bottom. Let's see how we can do that. Okay, first let's decide. Let's say that at this point, we want to stop resizing. So let's see what position means this. In order to know, I will just insert, for example, rectangle and put here, and I will look at the X position of the rectangle. So let's say 500. We will stop changing the size at 500. Okay, I'll delete the rectangle. It was just to get the number. So what we are going to do, since the gallery and this header, this container in the header are inside another container, we have the property minimum width for them. So let's choose both and set the minimum width to 500. So I will put 500 here in the minimum width property of both of them. And now, when I play the app, let's see what's going to happen. Let me just make it bigger to see. So we are decreasing the width of the app. At a certain point, it will get to 500. Maybe 500 was too little. Let's do a different approach. I will put a label and get the width of the gallery just to know in the screen when I play the app what happens. So I'll get the width of the gallery here. In the text property of the label, I will put dot width. And then I will play and see what's the width of the gallery in the moment I decide it's enough. Okay, so let's say here the width is 1500 and more. If I decrease, it starts to decreasing. Here I'm showing the width of the gallery in the bottom. Let's say then that's around here, so it's 675. 500 was too below this number, too much small. So let's say 675 for the minimum width of the gallery and the header container, 675. Okay, better now. Okay, let's play and see what happens. So I have a bigger gallery. Once I start decreasing, it also adapts the width, but in a certain point, we will get to 675 and it will stop decreasing. See? Now both the gallery and the container don't adapt anymore. But they don't show that part because it's hidden here in the outside the limits of the screen. So let's make show the scroll bar, and that's very easy because now we have the parent container, the cone main container example, and this container has this property called horizontal overflow. Right now it's saying hide. That's what happened when we decreased the width. It hid those labels that were beyond the size of the screen. Now I'm going to change from hide to scroll. So what's going to happen is when we have something inside the container that's wider than the container, it will show the horizontal scroll bar. Very simple as that. That's the way to create the horizontal scroll bar. You need to have the container with that property saying scroll, the horizontal overflow. Let's see. I'm going to play the app and I'm going to start decreasing the width. Once we get to 675, if we continue decreasing the width of the app, of the browser in this case, the container will start decreasing its width, but the gallery and the header will always have 675. That means that the content inside the container is wider than the container itself, and that's a horizontal overflow. And then the scroll bar will appear here in the bottom. It just appeared at 675. If I decrease more, everything inside is still 675, but the container is less than that. And then we have this bar that we can do this scroll. So this is the same concept I have inside this screen here. Where is it? Parts screen. So what's happening here is that at some point the gallery reaches its minimum size, and then the container has a horizontal overflow and it's showing the scroll bar. So it's configured in the main container that's in this section of the app. Let's go back to our screen. Let me delete this label, it's not necessary anymore. And we have this fully configured gallery that adapts to the width. And in a certain point, we have this scroll bar. As a last exercise, I'm going to create a blank screen. Not a blank now, but using this template, that's the sidebar template, and I'm going to put this inside the container, in the main container, where it would be the content of the screen, just to finish the lesson. So let's insert a new screen, select sidebar, that we already insert a blank screen, but with the containers inside. Look, this is the same structure as I have in my screen where I have things inside it. For example, in this header container, I can just insert my logo that I have uploaded in this the media part. So I'm going to select my logo, just adapt it in there really quick. And I could have the navigation here, and I want to insert the gallery here in this main container too. Okay, I'm going to go to my screen and I'm just going to copy what's inside this vertical container. So the header container and the gallery. Ctrl C, and I can go there and paste in there. Where is it? Screen 3. Maybe the gallery will lose the formatting, but maybe not. Let's see. Yes, it lost the same problem as a couple of lessons before. Actually, now the positions are fine, but the width got lost. So instead of doing this, I'll do a Ctrl Z. And I think we won't be able to find a way to move the gallery without needing to redo some formulas. So let me go to our screen, screen 1. I'm going to copy the header first and the gallery. So I'll do Ctrl X to cut the header and paste inside that container, Ctrl V. Since it has the formulas already to adapt the width, it will go fine. But for the gallery, I suspect that once we move it, it will lose the some references. So let's do Ctrl X, cut, and I'm going to paste here, Ctrl V. See, it lost the formulas, even though we had put formulas in the X and the width of the labels. So we would need to do again some formulas here, linking to the form to the position of the labels in the top, as we did a couple of videos ago in this playlist that the links in the first comments. I undid the changes and I will do one last try, that's copying the container, the whole container with the gallery inside. So I'll do Ctrl X in the container, go here in this container, the main container where we have already the header, and paste the other container inside it. It doesn't work anyway, so right now there is no way to move galleries between containers. It doesn't work well. It happens a lot, but now you know how to do the formulas. You can check the video again and fix this. I will let as an exercise, let me know in the comments if you could fix and if this series of videos was useful to you. See you in any future video. Bye bye.